Hello everyone, this is Dr. Indhumathi Kuberan, consultant diabetologist from Mumbai. Welcome to Diabetes Eye Openers with Dr. Indu. Today I'm going to educate you about thyroid disorders. The most commonest thyroid disorder which we encounter in practice is hypothyroidism, where the gland does not produce enough hormones and the patient becomes overweight, there is dry skin, falling of hair, menstrual irregularities, irritability, mood swings, and this can be easily treated with a single tablet of thyroxine. There is another type of thyroid disorder which I feel the public doesn't know much about. That is hyperthyroidism, where the gland overworks and produces a lot of hormones. Here, the patient will have in their reports high T3, T4 and a suppressed TSH, that is thyroid stimulating hormone. There are two types of hyperthyroidism. One type is subacute thyroiditis, where the patient has severe neck pain, fever, and the patient, if you see their reports, there will be very high ESR and CRP indicating inflammation of the gland. These patients do not need any anti-thyroid drugs like neomeprazole or methimazole. They just need anti-inflammatories. And in very severe cases, we give steroids so that the symptoms come down. These patients are not a candidate for anti-thyroid drugs. Whereas there is another category who have more severe symptoms, who have a longer duration of symptoms. That is called Graves' disease. These patients have anti-thyroid receptor antibodies in their blood, which destroys the gland. They need long-term treatment with anti-thyroid drugs like neomeprazole and or methimazole. The dose is adjusted according to their T3, T4 and TSH levels, which is checked every 3 months. T3 and T4 are hormones secreted by the thyroid gland, and TSH is secreted by the pituitary in response to T3 and T4. So thyroid stimulating hormone levels decide the mode of treatment for thyroid disorders. Thank you.